Hello everyone, this is Amanda, also known as Dr. Mommy Budgets, coming back to you again with another video. Today is Friday, June the 19th, 2020. I am here today to do my week 3 budget recap for the month of June 2020. And if you can recall, the date is June 19th. Therefore, today is known as Juneteenth Day. And there's been some talk lately here about people not really knowing what that is or hadn't heard of it or whatever the case may be. So just for my followers that are on my channel, I am going to bring you up to speed on what that actually is. Actually, I'm going to read a little clip from CNN that they happen to put out so that you can know what it is all about. So one second, let's see here. They actually did a nice representation of the flag as well. I know there may be also some people that don't even know what the flag looks like, but let's go. I'm going to see if I can show you that picture also. But June 19th. So June 19th, 1865 represents the day that enslaved Black people in Galveston, Texas became Americans under the law. And while African, this is just a little blurb that they added, but that's in essence is what happened. And of course, if you want to go into more detail, then you can just Google Juneteenth and you can get a lot of history on that. And while African Americans, this is just the end of it, and while African Americans today are still fighting for equality and justice, Hath, who was actually the guy who created the flag, and those colors, said those colors in the flag symbolizes the continuous commitment of people in the United States to do better and to live up to the American ideal of liberty and justice for all. And of course, you know, that's also another video, another whole video for another day. But anyway, also the flag, let's see here. CNN said, you might see another flag, white and red, white and blue, flying today over state capitals and city buildings. That banner with a bursting star in the middle is the Juneteenth flag, a symbolic representation of the end of slavery in the United States. The flag is the brainchild of activist Ben Hath, who is the founder of the National Juneteenth Celebration Foundation. Hath created the flag in 1997. With the help of collaborators and Boston-based illustrator Lisa Jean Graff. They too brought their visions together. But that's what I wanted to say. So basically the flag was revised in 2000 into a new version that we know today. And so that's pretty much my little spiel on Juneteenth. But let me see if I can go back and show you a picture of what the flag actually looks like. You may not be able to see it because of the glare of my phone, but I'll do the best I can with it. So that's kind of what you got there. It is red, white, and blue. And you have the star in the center. And then you have another bursting star that's going around that one, and it has the date on the side, June 19th, 1865. So yeah, there you have it. If you want to know more about Juneteenth, which people are celebrating all around the country today, then go do some history checks on that. So that is my little Black history tidbit for today. All right, let's get back into this video. As I stated, if you are interested in seeing my week 3 budget projection, then stick around for the rest of this video. Okay, everyone, as you can see, we're back and we're going to dive very quickly into this week 3 budget projection. I'm going to try to keep it very short since my introduction was pretty lengthy today. But as you can see, we have our caption here, or our description: week 3 budget projection, June 19th, 2020. And as I've already explained, today is Juneteenth day. So let's go on and dive right in with that. I've already actually got a text message, believe it or not, from my youngest asking if we can get fireworks for today. So yeah, I guess that's probably going to be a thing. But let's move along and get this budget projection done so that we can enjoy the rest of our day and I can give you back some of your day. All right. Well, I guess that depends on when you're watching it. Here we go. The first expense that we want to categorize is going to be the mortgage, where I will set aside $291.34. Okay, next we're going to move along to the HOA. That is $6.70, which I will put away for this week. The extra debt payment amount for this week is $262.77. Next, we have the auto insurance. This auto insurance is a monster, guys. $102 I set aside per week for that. Next, we have life insurance, which is $21. Then we have my Hulu account, which is an automatic draft of $5.99. Then we have the student loans, which I am not currently making payments on right now, set aside for $96.75, because there's no interest, no payment due until September of 2019, of 2020, or October of 2020. But I'm just kind of, you know, stashing that money away because, like I said, I have a daughter that's going away to college, and, you know, we just don't know what all is going to happen as we continue to go through this pandemic time frame. So I think I'd rather be as prepared as I can be. So yeah, I'm not making any payments on that right now. So my daughter's car fund, I set aside $20.50 per week for that, for her to get gas, get oil changes, whatever may need to be done on that vehicle. She actually just got a battery. And I'm thinking of that. I forgot to put that in my budget recap on yesterday. But yeah, she did get a battery for her car. So let's see, what else do we have? We have the household expenses, and this is $194 that I do take out in cash. Then we have the children's savings account. There's an automatic draft of $28.50 that I send to their accounts weekly. That's it, guys, for this week. So we have a total of $1,029.55 for this week. Okay, now I also like to leave a cushion in this account, and that cushion amount is $26.15. Okay, And I do that because I don't know what little odds and ends. Just like I just mentioned, my daughter want to do fireworks. So, you know, this kind of, you know, small amounts of money that's left in this bills checking account, I can just use my debit card and go and get little small items like that. So, now the total amount of my pay that I leave into this account each week is $1,228. So $1,228, which satisfies my debts. Okay, so if we subtract the $1,029.55 from that total left in the account, that gives us a total of $198.45, which is an overage, right? So we have that overage there because the debt total or expenses and debt total only come to $1,029.55. Also, remember, I like to leave the cushion in the account, so we're going to have to subtract that from the overage. So that $198.45, let's subtract the cushion of $26.15. Okay, that gives us $172.30. Okay? So at the end of the day, the $172.30 is technically what is going to be left as an overage. So we would put away into the bills savings account technically. And when I say technically, that means I'm moving it around on this paper. I'm not physically moving it around yet because we may need to subtract or add to that total. So for now, that number will get its famous blue cloud so that we can show the relationship. That is step one. Step two is to go back through the debts and put a PA beside each item that I am not paying this week. That means put away. So PA, the mortgage is not paid on the third week. It's paid on the second. The homeowners association is paid quarterly at the end of each third month. What else? The life insurance is not paid. It's paid one time a year in February. Student loans are typically paid on the fourth week. So we're dealing with the third week. And I think that's all that we have. Yeah, so these items will get the famous purple circle indicating that they are put away items. That's step number two. Step number three is to add up all of our PA amounts. So let's go back down here. And that PA total, for the sake of time, I have already calculated that. It is going to be $415.79. So now, as you can see here, we have another set of monies that we need to do something with, which is put away. Now, if you can see up above in the previous blue cloud, we are putting that amount away as well. So let's go through here and add those two amounts together. So we have the $172.30 that we need to put away plus the $415.79 that we need to put away. And I'm going to do that real quick on my calculator because I didn't have that as part of this recording. So we'll just do that real quick. That gives me $588.09. And that's supposed to be total put away into the bill savings account. And see, I'm still going to use technically here because we actually have a bill that we need to pay for this week. So now that we have that amount, let's go back up here and see what we're doing. Our next step is to put a
All right, guys, I'm hopping back on here real quick. I don't know why it is that I always forget to explain this, but that debt amount of $262.77, so $262.77, will be put away into my mini emergency fund for this week. Because as I've stated in previous videos, you know, I have a daughter that's going off to college, and yes, she is definitely going to need some things taken care of. So, yeah. That's what's going to happen with that. So I just wanted to hop on here to make sure that I did completely let you know what will be going on with all of these expenses and amounts of money. So that is it. And I will be signing off for real this time. This is Dr. Mommy Budgets. Peace.